sleep. If she...
Lately this morning, my good wife will be thrilled to see the first pair of pantaloons are serving the cause of scientific endeavor. Shall we begin?
Mr. Banks, may we ask why we're wearing bloomers? Underwear.
Follow me, you can do that as books for a start.
But we need them.
You want to study the world, don't you? Not print or paper. Why do the leaves change colour? Why does the hinge open the gate? Why when I step to and float off into the ether?
Because you're not a fairy.
No.
Because of gravitational force.
Welcome back, Woodland. So, do fairies exist?
Of course not.
Are you sure?
Perfectly sure.
But can you prove it? Where's the evidence? Judge a man by his question, not by his answers.
Rousseau.
Right country, wrong man.
Napoleon.
No.
Pierre Marc Gaston, Paris, 1808.
Name?
Miss Sullivan, sir.
To question is the hallmark of any worthy philosopher. The fool doth think that he is wise, but the wise man knows himself to be a fool. Shakespeare, the tale of the shrew.
Sir, it's as you like it. It's Touchstone. Act 5, Scene 1.
Slow, but correct. Now, you are about to experience...
So, can I just add? Oh, the room.
Yes, we are. Go on. Fill this interlude interruption yet again by Hilary Cassette. Thank you.
So sorry. It's really good. Really loving it. And does he know it's wrong?
Is it a test?
Is it a test? Am I testing?
Because he says slow, but correct. So has he set them up? Or does he not know because he's a scientist?
And then he's trying to corrupt.
Just a little pressure. Keep filming.
Slow, but correct. Now. You're about to experience a miracle of modern nature. Wait there.
What's he doing?
Apparently he's an eccentric.
How do you know?
My friend was there. He's at King's. At King's? A scholar.
Are you in Italy? We're just friends.
What in God's name?
Good Lord! A bicycle!
I hope he doesn't expect us to sit on it.
A marvel, a miracle of modern engineering. Have a look. Come on, come on. Now, what is this?
The wheel, of course.
It's not really a wheel. It's not merely a wheel, Miss...
Addison, Harrigan.
It's a nice horse. Without wheels, it's just a cumbersome chair. But with them, you can glide. The Mesopotamians invented the wheel to help them advance.
They didn't ride on bicycles.
No, they rode chariots. Now you.
Miss Moffat, sir.
On you get.
I couldn't possibly.
I thought you wanted to be a scientist.
Your Tess.
Go on. Turn around, please.
As you wish.
How do I get on? Just sling your leg over. Girls don't sling. Here, we'll help you. Ah! Don't look, for Christ's sake!
I'm sorry!
Right, you can turn around now.
Now, observe her demonstration of Isaac Newton's theory of mechanics.
But I'm not doing anything.
That's the first law of motion. That an object will continue in a state of rest known as...
Inertia.
Or at a constant speed, until it's affected by an outside force. In other words, Moffat's not going anywhere unless she applies some energy. If you could oblige...
How?
Put your foot on the pedal and push. Go on then, exert yourself.
Sir, I don't think it's very ladylike for me to exert myself.
You're not ladies now, Moffat. You're scientists.
Yes, sir.
Better. Now, watch how the wheel rotates. A sublime demonstration on Newton's second law, which is, Sullivan?
Acceleration of an object is directly proportional to the net force acting upon it.
And force is?
The product of mass and acceleration.
So the harder she pedals,
the greater the force. And the quicker she accelerates.
Now, if she were to ride to Midsummer Common, she might take a quarter of an hour. Provided she's not distracted by the cows or the roads.
Sir!
How far is it?
2 miles?
Blimey.
And the equation for speed is?
Distance divided by time.
1 mile every 7.5 minutes.
8 miles in an hour!
Woo! I had a bicycle when we lived in Athens.
Is there any way you'd have us lived?
No.
Now, Moffat, you're off, and you have a grasp of the basic laws of motion. You can predict the movement of any object through space. From the turning of a wheel to the trajectory of the planets. It's tremendous. Go on, fast!